Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory...
Welcome to our podcast, Significant Lovers. Cheers. We have some wine. We're drinking on the job. Anyone who just is joining me from my recent LinkedIn post about the podcast, welcome.
Oh.
Past colleagues or present or anybody else. Kind of scary posting about that on LinkedIn.
It is. Yeah.
You know, it's like you worry, have I always been professional? Is
probably not.
But anyone joining from LinkedIn, you can obviously see I have a lot of research skills.
Yes. Mel is always prepared for the podcast. Mm-hmm. Very thoughtful, very organized.
Timely,
dedicated,
reliable.
Yeah. Mel also does our social media and the creativity, that whole color scheme and everything going on, the leaves, that was her idea.
I appreciate that. Yeah. Branding is very
important.
Write
you. Oh, wait. Before this, we were saying, sorry, guys, we're going to get into the romance and everything, mm-hmm. but I was saying I should write you a recommendation, mm-hmm. and I was getting excited, but then you pointed out we're cousins, so it's a conflict of interest.
Yeah, I think... I don't know if people would take that too seriously. But Kelly, if anyone is looking for a recommendation on Kelly, she edits all the podcasts.
Oh.
So she has a lot of sound editing experience.
I'm a sound engineer.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
And
I don't know what I'm doing.
She works, she's steady with tight deadlines, I would say.
Oh, I'm steady with tight deadlines? Is that what you said?
You're steady under pressure with tight deadlines.
Yep. So, Mel...
When does this episode come out?
Is next it... week.
What were you going to say?
Well, this week, Mel is taking charge, leading mm-hmm. the story.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the audience this week.
Yes.
Who are we talking about?
We're talking about Justin Timberlake and Jessica Biel. What's going on with these two? They've been together. They've been married for 10 years.
Wow.
They just had their 10-year anniversary. Congratulations.
Congrats. Cool.
But their relationship is not without drama, and I think it goes under the radar. People aren't talking about this.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk about it, and... Yeah, I hope that everything is well for them. I would say my three words to describe them would be confusing, forgiving, and open,
Do you mean they're open with each other, they share a lot, or like it's literally an open relationship?
Either or. That's why it's confusing.
Okay.
Or... fake question mark.
No.
Because I don't know what's going on with these two.
Okay.
I don't know. I truly don't know what's going on with them. I actually feel like I don't know them
even
at all.
Even after all the research.
Yeah. Because I'm gonna, you guys are going to have whiplash throughout this whole relationship. You're going to feel like the reality that you believe in is not real, basically.
I mean, some people are very hard to know, and some people like to have a persona.
Mm-hmm.
And don't want people to know the real them. So some people are very hard to research. I actually did feel that way about the Jason and Olivia episode. By the end of it, I still felt like I didn't really know who they were.
That's kind of how I feel. Well, it's just the way that Justin and Jessica talk about each other in the press and on Instagram, it's so different from the things that you read. But...
Interesting.
I believe the things that they're telling me at the same time, unless they're just really good actors. So I'm like, what's the truth here?
Yeah.
Like, both things are true at the same time?
Would you really marry someone for 10 years on the basis of, like, nothing? Or, you know? We'll see.
I have no idea, honestly.
Not nothing.
But we'll learn together.
Cool.
So Jessica Claire Biel, she was born on March 3rd, 1982. That would make her a Pisces.
Ooh.
Anybody interested? In Ely, Minnesota, which she now is
cool.
40 years old. She was born to her mom, Kimberly, who was a homemaker and a spiritual healer.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And wow. Her dad, Jonathan, who's a business consultant for GE, and she's a little brother named Justin.
Freaky.
I know. That can be a deal breaker for some people, yeah. But not for Jessica. Her family moved around a lot throughout her childhood, but they lived in Texas, Connecticut, and Illinois, to name a few places. Yeah. And she was a singer growing up and did musicals. And when she was 11, she entered a modeling competition where she acquired an agent. And it seems like her career just kind of took off from that. At age 14 in 1996, she auditioned and landed the role of Mary Camden in the American family drama Seventh Heaven.
Mm.
Have you ever seen that?
Yeah, I used to watch it.
I've been thinking about just watching it.
When you mentioned it, I was like, what if that becomes my new show?
I know. I honestly, I kind of liked it, even though...
I liked it.
It was also...
I don't remember that well, but...
The pilot of this show, because I was watching some clips. So she plays Mary Camden. Her and her brother, almost kiss.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Matt.
Scandal.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Because she wants to learn how to kiss a boy because she has a crush. And so she's, trying to get her brother to, kiss her for practice.
Oh, my God.
It's not a good show, I think.
My mom used to always say that I looked like Ruthie.
You do kind of look like Ruthie.
She always would be like, that's you, Kelly.
Yeah.
So
it was on for many seasons.
Yeah. But I don't remember it too well.
Does anyone else feel 2000 shows are just so comforting these days?
Yes.
I've been watching Gilmore Girls, and it's just so comforting.
That's why I want to watch Party of Five.
Mm.
I still haven't gotten around to it, but it's more 90s, but it has that comfy feeling.
Yeah.
And it's good drama.
Yeah. I've been wanting to watch One Tree Hill.
Does Shannon know that?
No.
My sister, she loves One Tree Hill. Anyway.
Yeah.
So.
Then from there, Jessica acted in films like Yuli's Gold, never heard of it. I'll Be Home for Christmas.
Mm.
Summer Catch, never heard of it. And Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Oh,
have heard of it.
That, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Controversy, though. At 17 years old, Jessica posed topless on the cover of a magazine called Gear Magazine.
Wow.
Which actually is so scandalous, the pictures. And she's 17 years old. I don't know.
Can you see a lot?
You can't, actually see, nipple or anything, but she... It's a very sexy photo shoot, and it's...
She's 17.
She's 17.
Wow.
And so, obviously, the producers of Seventh Heaven were so mad about this, and I think they even sued the magazine because they were like, this is child pornography.
Yeah.
And, it makes sense that they were upset because Seventh Heaven is a family drama about a minister.
Yeah.
A very Christian family. Obviously questionable incest in the pilot episode, but I think a lot of people speculate that Jessica wanted out of her contract at Seventh Heaven. She just wasn't feeling it. She just didn't really like the show anymore. And after this incident, she appeared on the show less frequently. She was a reoccurring character for the fourth season, and then she was completely written off in the fifth season.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, and I just don't think she wanted to be on the show anymore. She denied that it was a calculated move, that magazine cover photo shoot. She said it was just her embracing her womanhood.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know the facts, obviously, but I kind of doubt you would think that that would immediately cause you to not be on a show anymore.
I don't know. It was a very scandalous photo shoot, and it's a very Christian show.
Yeah. But maybe it was a different time of the year or something, and she's just, I don't know. She has
true.
A full life and other things going on, and maybe, I don't know, she thought it wasn't connected, or maybe they wouldn't notice or something.
I don't know. Think when you're 17, it's that decision's not up to you.
Yeah. Everyone makes silly decisions when they're a teenager.
I don't even know if the show was mad at Jessica, but they were definitely mad at the magazine. And the magazine should not have had a scandalous photo shoot with someone so young. So, makes sense.
It was the times.
Mm-hmm. But then Jessica, during the fifth season of Seventh Heaven, that her final season, she also had been attending Tufts University in Massachusetts. So
cool.
Yeah, she's book smart. Before dating Justin, she had dated a guy named Adam Lavagorna from 1998 to 2001. He was her on-screen boyfriend in Seventh Heaven.
Ooh.
And he was also in the film I'll Be Home for Christmas with her. And then she also dated Chris Evans for 5 years.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
From 2001 to 2006. And apparently they were super serious and even talked about getting married. So maybe we'll cover them someday.
Yeah. I didn't realize that.
Mm-hmm. And she was rumored to have dated Derek Jeter briefly in 2006.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. So Justin Timberlake. Justin Randall Timberlake.
Randall? Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I didn't know it either. He was born in Memphis, Tennessee on January 31st, 1981. That makes him an Aquarius. He's 41 years old today. His mom is Lynn Bohr Harless. She had Justin at only 20 years old. And his dad is Charles Randall Timberlake. He's a former Baptist church minister.
Hmm.
Very Seventh Heaven.
True.
In 2011, Justin told Elle magazine, "My parents divorced when I was 3. I'm humbly and honestly finding out that I have a lot of issues with that. I'm finding more and more that I'm going to break the chain because that's what you want to do, break the chain of your parents. But at some point, it's in your blood and you have a thing that happens and you're like, holy shit, my parents did that. I read somewhere where the first 3 years of a child's life are the most important for the parents and the child's connection. And right around there, as soon as my parents had me, they divorced."
Man, he's really like looking back and struggling. Whoa.
So I think that's just good context to keep in mind.
Yeah. Okay.
For Justin. Thank you, Mel. That his parents are divorced and he's obviously done a lot of reflecting on that.
Yeah.
That it's obviously affected him later on. And then when Justin was just 5 years old, his mother remarried a man named Paul, who's a financial analyst. And at some point, Justin's dad also remarried and to a woman named Linda, and they had 2 sons when Justin was a preteen, Stephen and Jonathan, and they also gave birth to a baby girl in 1997 when Justin was 16 years old, but unfortunately the baby passed away shortly after birth.
Man, that's so sad.
I know. So he went through a lot when he was young. Justin was mostly raised by his mom, but he also had a close relationship with his grandparents too. And growing up, he sang gospel music. And at 11 years old, he competed on the show Star Search using the name Justin Randall, not Timberlake. And he's really cute. I watched clips of this. He's so cute. He's like yodeling or he's like very country twang. It's cute. So cute.
I remember Star Search, like hearing about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like it was totally eclipsed by American Idol.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He didn't win, but his appearance on Star Search helped him be cast on the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse, or the Mickey Mouse Club.
Mickey Mouse Club.
Yeah, Mickey Mouse Club. Alongside Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera, Ryan Gosling, Kerry Russell, and JC Chaz's. He's a member of NSYNC. I don't know how to pronounce his name, though. He was on that show from ages 12 to 13. And when Justin was 14, he had dated a girl from his hometown named Danielle Dito for 2 years. And at age 16... Oh, this is crazy.
What?
At age 16, Justin dated Fergie, who was 23. And they dated...
I didn't know that.
Yes, they dated for like almost a year.
Fergie Ferg. What was she even doing at the time?
I don't know.
Black Eyed Peas formed? I don't know if you know.
I don't
this,
know. She was 23.
She was 23.
It's like nobody's
she
ever
was
talked
16?
About that. Yeah.
You
know, he was 16.
He was 16.
Yeah, she was 23.
Wow.
So I feel like that's also
weird.
Good to keep in mind for
that's
Justin.
What the fuck?
But he's actually never single. So then, like, right after that ended, he dated a girl named Veronica Finn, a singer in the girl group called Innocence. And they dated for 2 years and then broke up in 1998. See, I just thought that he dated Britney right after the Mickey Mouse Club.
Yeah, and that's it.
Yeah, but they had not seen each other for years and then got together after he had been in NSYNC, which was formed.
That's cool.
Yeah.
We probably should cover them someday.
Yeah, definitely. That was like a big deal.
Yeah.
But NSYNC was formed when Justin was 15. He was approached about being put in a boy band by a musician named Chris Kirkpatrick, who had got the funding by a band manager named Lou Pearlman, who, this is like a can of worms. Yeah, he had like one of the biggest Ponzi schemes in all of America, apparently.
Wow.
Which is weird. I don't know enough about that, though. And then Justin recruited JC, what's this guy's name? JC
Chaz's,
yeah, from the Mickey Mouse Club to be in NSYNC. I'm not like an NSYNC person at all. And then also that was followed by Joey Fatone and Lance Bass, and they were immediately a huge hit. By 2002, they performed at the Oscars, the Winter Olympics, and the Super Bowl halftime show.
Wow!
And they were nominated for 8 Grammy Awards, although they never won, and they just became a part of the pop bubble at that time. And
the pop bubble.
Yeah. In 1998, Justin began dating Britney Spears, and their relationship was hugely publicized. And he also started to dip his toes into acting and was in the film Model Behavior. After their world tour for the Celebrity album, Justin was more and more interested in going solo, because boy bands were more and more on the out around this time. I think this was like 2002. So he suggested that the band go on hiatus, and it was meant to be a temporary hiatus, but they never got back together.
Poor NSYNC fans.
Mm-hmm. And Justin said it started as a fun snowball fight that was becoming an avalanche, and also I was growing out of it. I felt like I cared more about the music than some of the other people in the group, and I felt like I had other music I wanted to make that I needed to follow my heart. However, Joey Fatone and Lance Bass have said that they felt like it was not Justin's fault, but they thought it was really inconsiderate that Justin made it sound like it was temporary, even though he had no intention of going back to it, because all the other members were sitting around waiting and didn't do other opportunities. So
it's funny how he says like some of the other people, as if there's so many people that it could be. There's only a couple people it could be.
I don't think he has a lot of close friends, to be honest.
Making a sad face.
Mm-hmm. I think he's burned some bridges with these guys. I mean, they're not like
JT.
They're not enemies, but spoiler, like he doesn't even invite NSYNC to his wedding.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're really not friends anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And, okay, but I mean, always gotta see all the sides. Like, that might sound sad to us, but you do grow out of friendship. It's almost like your high school friend group. Some people that you were friends with in high school, you don't end up inviting to your wedding. It's like, that's so insane to think about, you know.
No,
like,
it's
people
not.
Grow apart.
Yeah. And I also think, like, to give Justin the benefit of the doubt, there might be jealousy coming from the other members, because he obviously was the front runner and the most successful one.
Yeah. That's tough.
So in 2002, he began his solo career with a more R&B influence and produced by the Neptunes and Timbaland, which is so weird. His name is Timberlake and he works with Timbaland.
Yeah.
Kind of confusing.
When I was little, I got very confused about that.
Yeah, me too.
And the shoes too.
Yeah, what a coincidence.
Yeah.
He had big top 5 singles such as Cry Me a River and Rock Your Body. And this is right after Justin and Britney had broken up after 4 years of dating. So the song, that fueled a lot of anti-Britney backlash, because it was rumored she had cheated on him. And it kind of made Justin like this victim.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people saw him as like this all-American boy, and they felt really bad for him. So that song like made Justin a lot more popular.
I've heard people say they feel like that wasn't really true, or like that was kind of manufactured on his part, you know, to seem
Well,
heartbroken.
As we get more and more into his relationship with Jessica, it's just kind of weird that so much of his image was based off being a boy who was cheated on.
Really?
Ooh. It's like kind of rich that
life is funny that
way. Yeah.
I do love Cry Me a River though.
Me too.
It's a good pop song.
Yeah.
I love the beginning with that kind of opera sounding voice. It's like, yeah.
My sun, you were my earth. You didn't know all the ways I loved you.
It is a really good song.
Anyway,
after that breakup, he then went on a few dates with Jenna Dewim from Step Up, and
she was way more famous than she should be. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Maybe I was being this. No, but she's always in like tabloids still, and I don't know why.
Yeah, I can't name anything else she's been in.
I know.
Besides Step Up.
And she was with Channing Tatum. Mm-hmm.
From Step Up.
Yeah. Sorry.
I mean, she's very pretty and stuff.
Yeah.
But, he also then dated Alyssa Milano for a few months, and they split in 2003. And then right after that, he dated, how do you say her name? Tatsalan Ali. She played Ashley Banks on Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. He dated her for a few months. And then in 2003, he began dating Cameron Diaz after meeting her at the Kids' Choice Awards, and they were in a pretty serious relationship for a couple of years.
Wow. Mm-hmm. He has so many relationships.
One after another, and it's going to keep happening. And of course, there was the whole Super Bowl halftime show.
Oh, yes. With Janet,
yeah. He ripped off her shirt, and that was very controversial.
Shocked America.
Mm-hmm. And after that incident, he kind of took a break from music to focus on acting and become the actor that he's also known as. So he didn't really face consequences from that whatsoever. Like, in a way, he was like kind of victimized for that too, even though it's like, you're the one who did it.
Yeah, it was odd. It was very scandalous, though. People were like freaking out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It was like the slap, the Oscar slap.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's but bigger, deal. I think.
Yeah. And the following Super Bowl, I remember they had Paul McCartney play, which I love him now, but I'm pretty sure back then people were like, this is boring. So it's just like him and a guitar. But I think they were like afraid. The Super Bowl needed to like repair its image because they had like a topless woman last year. So they were trying to like.
People are so annoying about the Super Bowl. It's like.
Yeah, people Oscar get very hunk. Uptight about yeah. the Super Bowl.
Who cares?
Like everyone becomes a critic that 45 minutes or whatever.
Yeah, everybody. It's like everybody has an opinion. Like to me, it's like whatever.
Seriously, every year it's like, what did you think of the halftime show?
Yeah. I'm like, I think it's fine. Great?
Yeah. Boring.
Yeah. There's honestly impossible standards for the halftime
Same
show.
Same for the host of the Oscars.
Yes, exactly.
You cannot please.
No, people get so mad. I'm like, honestly, it was fine.
Whenever they announce who it's going to be, whatever. I don't really care.
Yeah. Every single year, it's like, have we not learned from the past years that, like, no one's ever going to be happy ever?
Yeah, no one is ever happy.
No. Justin, it's so funny because Justin's made 3 appearances at the Super Bowl.
Wow.
So, that might be a record, I'm not sure.
That is a lot.
Anyways, though, how did they meet? So, Justin and Jessica met at a birthday party that Justin was hosting for one of his friends. This was in, I think, late 2006.
Isn't this around when Future Sex Love Sounds comes out?
Yes. So this is kind of a peak of Justin's career.
I love that CD.
Yeah. Bring so good. Sexy back. Yeah, actually, that CD is added to the Rock Hall of Fame library.
Wow. Mm-hmm. I think it deserves it.
Yeah.
I love it. I'm not really, like, much of a pop person, I guess, but I do love that album. I think
it's great. Wait, what other songs are on there besides Sexy
love
Back?
Love Stoned. Do you remember that one?
No.
It's like... She knows it. She's freaky, but I like it. Listen. She grabs the yellow bottle. She likes the way it hits her lips. She gets to the bottom. It sends her on a trip. So right. She might be going home with me tonight. There's other songs too, but I'm forgetting them. That are notable, but I don't remember.
That really is the peak of Justin's career. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Justin later wrote in his memoir,
Here's a memoir?
Yeah. I probably should have gotten this, but he said, we were at a speakeasy kind of bar, private club, and we were standing around in a group of people. I made some sort of sarcastic comment, really dry. Nobody got it except her. She laughed, and I noticed all of a sudden, and in the way where you wonder if a person likes you, if they have a very dry, dark sense of humor. No, if a person is like you.
Oh, okay.
If they have a very dry, dark sense of humor, too. We talked that night. The DJ played Lucky Star, and we danced. And then she was gone. My friend then brought her to my show. They were with a whole crew of girls, and they all came into the dressing room and hung out. After the show, they were all going back to LA, and I was going to Anaheim. I asked if they wanted to come with me. I'll give you a ride. You can come on my bus if you want. And they did. Jess and I talked the whole way up, joking around. Before she got off the tour bus, I said, can I have your number? And in a 2002 article with Us Weekly, he said, there was nothing starry about the way we got together. It was very un-Hollywood-esque. In fact, we met and got talking. Afterward, I asked my friend if I could call her and ask her out. So my friend called Jessica, and Jessica said yes, so I called her. And apparently, she originally said no, but then he was very persistent. But get this, he was still dating Cameron Diaz at this time.
Justin!
So that's why she said no.
Oh, Justin. Mm-hmm. That sneaky little bitch.
Mm-hmm.
I was listening, but while you're talking, I looked up the album, because I know there's other songs you know on it, and there are. There is the song My Love. It's like, no, no one could take us to my love.
Oh, yeah.
And then there's, what goes around, goes along my back around. And that might be it. Oh, wait, Summer Love. This just can't be summer.
Yes. I forgot. That really puts me back to fourth grade.
Yeah, so that's like 1, 2, 3, 4, like 4 hit songs? 5 hit songs? But anyway, back to this.
Yeah.
That was a really cute story until I heard that part.
I know.
I think that happens a lot, though.
Yeah, and at least he did then break up with Cameron Diaz, but get this.
What?
Rumors say that he broke up with Cameron Diaz because he was pursuing/seeing Scarlett Johansson.
Okay. What the fuck? Clearly, he just has ladies all over.
Mm-hmm. Especially at this point, it's like Justin Timberlake is kind of the hottest person to date.
Yeah.
But I don't think him and Scarlett ever panned out. But so January 11th, 2007... that's when it's news breaks that Justin Timberlake and Cameron Diaz had officially broken up. Just four days later, it's the Golden Globes.
Mm-hmm.
And Justin and Cameron Diaz are both reportedly friendly during the ceremony at the Golden Globes. However, at Prince's after party, this is widely reported on. Like, so this definitely happened. Cameron Diaz sees Justin flirting with Jessica Biel, and this is after that whole birthday party, too.
Mm-hmm.
And Cameron Diaz just blows up, according to all these reports. And so Jessica then walked away, and Cameron and Justin have an intense 40-minute argument in another room.
No way. Mm-hmm.
And apparently Cameron is like, so you're seeing her now? Like, and I get it.
Yeah,
you just broke up
4 days later.
Yeah.
4 days.
Mm-hmm. Especially since I think Jessica or Cameron thought that Justin was breaking up with her over Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah.
And he's already talking to another girl, too.
Oh, my God, Justin.
I don't blame Cameron Diaz. Reports say
this is so exciting.
Diaz reemerged looking composed, but not before Timberlake held his head in his hands, says a witness, slammed his fist down onto a cabinet.
A little dramatic. Mm-hmm.
And when Justin is talking about his relationship with Jessica, he talks about the birthday party and pursuing her, and in his memoir he writes, then the Golden Globes came up and that's when we planned on seeing each other. We were both still seeing other people, keeping ourselves safe from getting hurt, from really putting ourselves out there. It took a bit for both of us to admit to ourselves that we really, really were into each other. So sounds like him and Cameron like weren't fully over it.
Yeah, no, it's funny the way he's putting it.
January 25th, they're spotted snowboarding together in Utah. And in May, Justin embarks on his world tour for the Future Sex Love show. And the Daily Mail published photos of him and Jessica kissing in the UK. And apparently he flew her out to Manchester. And sources say Justin's really into Jess. And when he found out she had some free time, he asked her to join on the UK leg of the tour. And they're both doing everything they can to keep their relationship low profile, but when they're among friends, they can hardly keep their hands off of each other. And a source tells People that Justin is in love with Jessica and wants to be serious with her, and they're photographed holding hands and kissing in a lot of tabloids. In June, Jessica is interviewed in GQ, but she declines to comment on Justin. And Justin is interviewed that same month, and he says that Jessica is a very, very dear friend. And he's also asked who the love of his life is, and he responds, I haven't met her yet.
What? Justin.
Yeah.
The fuck, man?
In August.
Why did they ask that,
though? I know. They kind of set him up. In August, Star Magazine, which who knows if this is true, they're not credible, but they report that Jessica Biel was seen at a wedding with Chris Evans while Justin is on tour, and that eyewitnesses claim that they were cuddling and flirting and kissing.
But it is Star Magazine.
It is. A rep for Evans says that they're just friends, but a source who saw the two say you can tell that she and Chris were close and had history together. Toward the end of the night, I overheard Chris say, come on, let's get out of here. And they left together. He was really adamant, like he was really in a hurry to go and take her with him. But in his memoir, Justin admits that him and Jessica weren't exclusive until the end of his tour, which ended in December 2007.
Oh. So who knows what was going on?
Yeah, I think they were casual, so nothing counts at this point. And throughout the rest of 2007, they are photographed together, but I don't think they're exclusive. So they are still seeing other people while they're seeing each other. Jessica was reportedly in talks to play Wonder Woman, but she turned it down at this time, too.
Why'd she do that?
I don't know. Kind of weird. I feel like she'd be so much more famous.
Yeah, I know.
Maybe she doesn't care about that, though.
She doesn't care about the fame.
No. 2008, beginning in January, according to Blind Items on Crazy Days and Nights, Justin was seen at a club making out with Kate Hudson while Jessica was off in the UK filming her film Easy Virtue. Okay.
All right. Justin, okay, I mean, I don't know if that's true, but it seems like he has a lot of women that are interested in him and he doesn't have much self-control.
I don't think he has any self-control. And younger years, it's like very famous women. Now it's like backup dancers.
Oh.
Not to spoil it, but.
Well, his contemporaries or whatever. I mean, everyone's older.
Mm-hmm.
No one's gonna fuck up their relationships or whatever to like cheat with Justin Timberlake.
Yeah, you know exactly. I mean? So Justin does look a lot older now.
Yeah,
he's not really the guy he used to be.
It's different when you're like 40. Like, yeah. Everyone wouldn't be acting the same way, I don't think.
No, yeah. I don't think so.
So it makes sense. It's like younger backup dancers.
Also that month, or I don't know when it was, but Justin and Jessica are photographed together a lot, but nothing too remarkable or juicy comes out. There are reports that they're just like always holding hands. Like they always look very in love.
So these are like
paparazzi.
Them on the street type of pictures. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Cute.
Did they pose them? You know, I don't know. June 2008, at the premiere of the Love Guru film, Justin's co-star Trace Aaliyah is asked about whether he thinks Justin and Jessica will get married soon. And he says, I hope so. He says, to be honest, I don't see wedding bells in the future, but I hope so. I really do. It is not just Jessica. It is also him when he is with her. It is awesome. They are just awesome together. She is just a great girl.
That's nice.
I know. And according to In Touch magazine, Jessica moves into his 6-bedroom mansion in LA and they're photographed out in LA shopping for home decor together.
6 bedrooms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's like too many.
That's like too many.
And you're mid-20s? Why do you need all those bedrooms? In September 2008, Joey Fatone is asked if Justin is getting married. I don't know what everybody wants to know so badly. He says, I think he finally met somebody that he wants to spend the rest of his life with. You never know, but I don't know if it's the appropriate time right now. You know what? I think he's just playing it by ear. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Seems like people are saying no.
Yeah.
Nicely.
Mm-hmm. October, Justin and Jessica are photographed all over Rome on vacation before she is a bridesmaid in her friend's wedding. And even though Jessica seems to claim that she's a private person in interviews and not talk about her love life, people online say that she's has like an incredible publicist who is always working with magazines to maintain her relevancy. Mm. And including staging paparazzi photos, maybe.
Maybe.
Lainey Gossip.
I wish you guys could see Mel's face when she said that.
Lainey Gossip is so funny. When I was reading she like hates Justin Timberlake and she kept calling him like Pip or something. And I was reading articles from this time period, like, she did not think that they were a real couple at all. Yeah. Wow. But that Jessica is so savvy with her publicity and wants people to really believe it.
Wow. I don't get why. It doesn't add up to me, though, like, why she would turn down such a big role as Wonder Woman. Maybe she had another reason, but, like,
yeah,
it seems like professionally she isn't really trying to be in the spotlight as much, or like,
I agree,
wasn't as aggressive about roles.
Yeah, I don't get why she would turn down Wonder Woman, or even like how she just kind of gave up Seventh Heaven, like she wasn't into it. It's like, is it like she wants to be famous without actually acting?
But she doesn't want to work.
She does act though, and she has produced films and written for film before, so.
Yeah, I was just joking.
No, but I agree, though. It's, like, kind of weird she turned down that role. Because it seems like if she really was fame-hungry and calling paparazzi, wouldn't she take advantage of that?
Yeah, maybe, like, there was another reason. But,
I don't know. She acts like she's very private, but I don't think she is, because she's photographed a lot. So in November 2008, Justin hosts SNL, and Lainey Gossip reports that he was spotted flirting with Natalie Portman at the after party. She says she and Pip were rather giggly, an innocent enough flirtation. They didn't leave together or anything, but there was a significant amount of time spent whispering and laughing, described to me as though they seemed totally into each other, and at one point, because she's so short, he bent his knees to look right into her eyes to tease her about something and held on to her elbows to drive the point home, and she threw her head back, and Jessica Biel is like already on a plane over from LA with her shelf ass ready to shut him down.
Oh my god. Jeez.
I know. End of that year, Jessica poses for the cover of GQ UK, and when asked why she doesn't talk about her relationship with Justin, she says, it's the one part of my life that is my own and not for anybody else. She also calls him her sparkly present and says, I don't want to open it in front of strangers.
Interesting.
All these celebrities say that.
I know. Sometimes I feel like people make too much of a point to be like, I don't talk about it.
Yeah, exactly. Like, how unique.
I know.
I don't know. So 2009, throughout that year, there are constant rumors that they split up, but it's never confirmed. And Justin's grandmother, Sadie, she reportedly tells a magazine called Closer Weekly Jessica was keen to marry, but Justin isn't ready. He's been writing new material, and he works hard to be successful. He's really focused on that. As far as we're concerned, he's always been single. The girlfriends come and go, but we believe nothing has ever been serious. Justin does his own thing, and he isn't ready to marry just yet.
This is her grandmother?
Justin's grandmother.
Oh, Justin's grandmother.
Yeah.
Oh, he's always been single.
It's like, is Justin's grandmother even in on his, like, womanizing ways?
Yeah. Seems like she is.
Yeah, I think so. They're like, yeah, she's a great girl and everything, but...
He's just doing his thing.
And
oh my god.
I don't know. I feel like some people think, like, well, if you're not married, then you're single.
I know.
Yeah.
That's at least a thing in the movies.
Yeah.
Especially from, like, the 90s. They're like, well, he's not married.
Mm-hmm.
Like, well, does he have a girlfriend? Like, does that matter?
Yeah. Like, it's so funny. Yeah, from, like, the different perspective. Like, if your friend was interested in someone, well, he's not married. But if your friend was dating somebody.
I know.
And they cheated on them.
Yeah. I don't know.
I think someone who is... not married but in a relationship is not single.
I know.
Like, we really have to define these terms.
But grandma seems to think he's never been that committed.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Even when he says he is.
Mm-hmm. She'll come up later too.
Whoa.
His grandmother. E! News gossip columnist Ted Casablanca told ABC News that he's heard from multiple people who know them that their writing is on the wall and that it's not going to work out between Justin and Jessica.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. But... in September, they attend an NBA basketball game, and, well, NBA means basketball, and to dispel rumors, they really overdo it on the kiss cam, and, like, he's full-on, like, on top of her.
Whoa.
Isn't that crazy?
He was on top of her, kissing her. I like his little hat, I must say.
Yeah, it is cute.
It's nice to see a picture. And guys... if you don't already, you can see pictures of all these people on our Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful black and white pictures. Because we're nostalgic like that.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, back to the story.
So yeah, I feel like they're trying to prove a point to us. And it works because I fall for it. I think they do look in love there.
Yeah. Well, how do we know they're not?
We don't know, but it's rumored that they're about to break up at this point.
Well, what if it's one of those things where, like, they love each other?
His grandmother is calling him single.
They love each other, but he keeps fucking up.
Probably. But Justin also hosts SNL, and Jessica Biel, he hosts SNL and is the musical guest. Jessica Biel is the one who introduces him as the musical guest. Okay, so we're in 2010 now.
Okay.
So... there are rumors that Justin is reportedly hooking up with Rihanna.
What the fuck?
Mm-hmm, in January. And a blind item...
Riri.
Yep, Riri.
How does Drake feel about this?
I know. and a blind item that she was seen... says that she was seen giving him a lap dance at a club. I hope not. But that same month, Jessica Biel is interviewed by Vogue magazine... and the writer says, amid the German techno music and the Madonna Justin Timberlake song 4 Minutes suddenly blasts over the sound system, we stare down at our plates awkwardly. Biel looks up at me and with a big smile on her face, punctures the silence. Dance break. We had another awkward moment in the car during our drive when Biel was talking about her style. I really like uber feminine classic-looking things mixed with something rougher around the edges. I've been looking at Rihanna a lot, checking her out. She's got something going on that I'm sort of craving a little bit. I nearly choked on my trail mix. I could not tell whether this was a Freudian slip, some worrisome single white female voodoo, or a calculated little piece of spin designed to show me that she is unthreatened by the rumors that her man has eyes for the diva from Barbados.
What? That's crazy.
Isn't that so crazy? Like, I mean, sexually? It's that same month.
Yeah.
That same month. She's like, oh, I've been checking out Rihanna, and I want to be like her.
That is... uncanny.
Mm-hmm.
That can't be a coincidence.
No, that has to be calculated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That same month, Jessica climbed Mount Kilimanjaro with rapper...
Really?
Mm-hmm. Rapper Lupe Fiasco.
Oh, yeah.
And there are rumors that they're together.
Oh.
But he denies that and says they're just good friends.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite... Yeah, that's friendship. How did that happen? They hiked Kilimanjaro together?
I think they did it for some type of documentary, maybe. Okay. It was, like, filmed for something.
Wow.
But very impressive on her part. That's hard to do.
Yeah, our friend of our old pod,
mm-hmm.
I don't know about our current pod, but yeah. Your friend Dan hiked that, right?
Mm-hmm.
He said it was, like, horrible.
Torture. Yeah. It was, like, truly awful. People were, like, having diarrhea on the course. God. And,
yeah, it sounds scary.
Getting airlifted. In February of that year, at a fashion show, Justin's mom tells reporters that Jessica is one of us. And that the two are very affectionate and always trying to do special things for each other. She says, I've had friends who have grandchildren, and I've tried to express to him that I'm losing that race. But I have grandpuppies. Justin has two boxers, and she has a pit bull who's now part of the family. I said, I'll leave you alone about the grandkids as long as you leave the puppies with me.
Hmm.
And in March of that year, Jessica is asked by Marie Claire if she's looking to settle down and get married. And she says, I'm just happy with life right now. And then also that month, Justin is filming the movie Bad Teacher alongside
Cameron Diaz.
Mm-hmm. And I think they have a sex scene in it. I'm not sure. I've never seen it.
I think I did see that movie, but it was so long ago.
Mm-hmm. They almost filmed that movie at my middle school.
Really?
But my middle school wouldn't allow it because it was called...
Squares.
Yeah, because it was so raunchy. Yeah, they are squares. Like, that would have been so cool.
Yeah.
But that's pretty chill of Jessica to be fine with him being in a movie with his mm-hmm. ex who had... like yelled at her.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy they were able to act together like
mm-hmm.
that. Wow.
And promote the movie together too.
Man.
I think they literally have. Guys, am I wrong? I haven't seen like it.
That sounds true. It's been so long.
They're very like flirty at least mm-hmm. in the movie from what I saw on YouTube. I wasn't gonna watch the movie for this, but in April there are rumors and some reports that Justin and Jessica broke up. But neither of them confirm it.
Mm.
And in May, they attend the Met Gala together, and they're very affectionate. Like, they're holding hands, and they seem very in love. In the fall, many publications start reporting that Justin supposedly cheated on Jessica with Olivia Munn.
Oh, my. Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm not getting you. Olivia Munn. Do you guys remember her from our John Mulaney episode?
Wow.
Olivia Munn has a little bit of a reputation for being with guys in relationships.
I think we said that.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And apparently they spent 3 days at a hotel together. Like, this is widely known. Like, it's reported in too many places to just be a rumor. And he allegedly met Olivia at a MySpace party and was chasing her immediately. And apparently, yeah, they spent 3 days together at the Park Avenue Hotel and supposedly had amazing sex, according to sources. Who are the sources? Probably Olivia's friends, who she's telling everything to, because...
Oh, my gosh.
She's very fame-hungry. But Olivia's... So Justin denies the story, but Olivia's rep says no comment.
Mm-hmm. Why would... Yeah, that's weird. Why would you say no comment if it wasn't true?
Because Olivia, like, as a correspondent for The Daily Show or whatever, she should not be famous. But she so badly wants to be famous, and I think this is a part of her origin story with us.
Yeah.
She... like, was probably obsessed with the fact that she was hooking up with Justin Timberlake.
I mean, he's equally at fault here.
Yeah, 100%.
But we're just, like, carrying this into the John Mulaney episode.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, but that's why we know about it. It's because I think Olivia is telling her friends because she wants this to be publicized.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
And then, so, in 2011, Justin keeps denying reports about hooking up with Olivia, but Life and Style reports that he keeps texting her. They say, Justin Timberlake is up to some old tricks in the new year. Though he denied reports last fall that he cheated on longtime girlfriend Jessica Biel, 28, with actress Olivia Munn, Life and Style has learned he's still reaching out to Olivia. Over New Year's weekend, an insider reveals the perfect couple's star, 30, was showing her phone to a few friends. She had several new text messages from Justin on it, the insider says. They'd all been sent very recently, the last few weeks of December. And they were hardly innocent. One said, "My relationship is basically over," says the insider to Life and Style. The other said, "I'm thinking about you." There was part of a third that said something like, "You don't understand how hard it is." Oh, I didn't see the entire text, so I'm not sure how that sentence ended, says the source. Rep for Justin, 29, declined to comment. Olivia says the insider is texting back yet keeping her distance. She's super flattered, says the insider, but she's not stupid. She's not expecting it to go anywhere, but she'd love it if it did.
Yeah, she would.
Yeah, she would. Again, yeah, like, this is Justin's fault. And, like, I feel like if I was in Olivia's place, I would also be showing this to my friends. Yeah. Of course I would.
Yeah, of course. Duh. How could you keep it a secret? But I just gotta say, if we have anyone younger listening, or even older, who is lost in their love lives or something, if you're ever talking to someone and they say that, like, their relationship is ending soon, or, like, it's basically over, or they're separated but they're still together or something, don't listen to them.
No,
it's not true. Don't.
Yeah, it's not like a job where you're, like, interviewing before. Yeah, you,
it's like, oh, I can't leave yet, like, I'm trying to.
It's like, oh, but I can't get my 2 weeks at my relationship right now.
Like, they're playing both of you.
Yeah,
don't listen to that. I feel like I hear that sometimes, just even, like, in the real world, and it doesn't work out.
No, it never does. But I do think that, I'm not to shit on Olivia Munn, but it's just so weird. If you guys want to listen to our John Mulaney episode, it does seem like she has a pattern of getting with guys who are in relationships or fresh out of relationships, especially very famous guys.
Yeah.
And she does seem a little bit social climbing-esque.
Some people, it's wrong, but they are really turned on by being with someone that's in a relationship or married.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's her fetish, I guess.
Yeah. It's crazy. Anyway.
But that's totally, again, Justin's fault there. If it's true, it also could not be true at all.
Could be totally fake.
But again, where there's smoke, there's fire. That was actually
how much smoke does it have to be?
That was, like, there's a lot of reports about that. I mean, maybe it's, like, one article wrote it and then a ton of other articles just copied them, but I don't know.
Yeah.
In February of that year, People Magazine reports that Justin Timberlake and his co-star from Friends with Mila Kunis, or from Friends with Benefits, Mila Kunis, were inseparable at the SAG after party, and they had clear chemistry. But sources say that they're just friends and that Jessica and him are still going strong. And Lainey Gossip writes, "On many levels, I have two sources who saw them together, like Justin and Mila. Like, not fucking or anything, but they were tight. They wanted to be with each other. There was chemistry. It was flirty. My sources are not up a publicist's ass. People's sources, however, could very well be. And Justin and Mila are in a movie together called Friends with Benefit. It couldn't hurt to exploit whatever it is going on or not going on between them to start early promotion for the film. Mm-hmm. Even if that means hurting poor Jessica Biel." Even if that means hurting poor Jessica Biel. I thought I'd turn this off.
Yeah, what is going on with Jessica Biel? She's just standing here while all these reports are coming out that she's with... No, that Justin is flirting with so-and-so. This is, like, the third one.
Yeah.
Or fourth?
Olivia Munn.
Cameron... I don't know.
He was in a film with
Natalie Cameron. Portman.
Natalie Portman. Cameron Diaz.
Yeah.
Rihanna. Four.
The fuck?
That's a lot. The People article is quick to offer assurance from another source. And, this is what Lainey Gossip says. The People.com article is quick to offer assurance from another source. Jessica herself? That she and Jessica are solid, very much still a couple, and that he and Mila are no more than friendly colleagues. Sure. Here's more believable excuse. Oh, and then I think she's, like, talking about how they're probably just promoting the film again.
Mm-hmm.
But just a month later, it's reported that Justin and Jessica have officially broken up.
What?
So, seems like there might be some truth to those rumors. And for the first time ever, even though there's been so many, like, many times, reports that they've broken up, this is the first time they've ever confirmed it.
Wow.
And, their rep says, addressing the media speculation regarding Jessica Biel and Justin Timberlake's relationship, we are confirming that they mutually have decided to part ways. The two remain friends and continue to hold the highest level of love and respect for each other. And a source describes it as mutual and that Jessica is doing fine.
What?
And then just a month later, Justin is spotted cozying up to Olivia Wilde, who had just filed for divorce from her husband, Prince Tao Raspoli, a month prior, and they were spotted snuggling at a nightclub and leaving together at 3 a.m. And I didn't realize...
That was, like, one sentence in that episode.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Our last episode, and yeah. I didn't realize that Olivia played Justin's mom in the movie In Time.
Yeah. She did.
Is there, like, a time jump in that, or...?
I actually saw that movie in theaters, weirdly.
Oh, really?
And I think it was, like, people stopped aging.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Some kind of futuristic thing. So she looked young still, but was his mom.
Obviously, that was a short relationship, I think. But, okay, so since...
Crazy.
Since him and Jessica got together, he's been rumored to be with... Rihanna,
mm-hmm.
Olivia Munn, Olivia Wilde, Mila
Flirted
Kunis,
with Natalie Portman.
Yeah, Natalie Portman. And then also kind of Scarlett Johansson at the same time that first got together with Jessica. But so there's still at this point rumors about him and Mila Kunis being together, and they deny it. But at the MTV Movie Awards, which again, this is probably just PR in June. And again, he's not with Jessica, so he's free to date anybody he wants.
Yeah.
But I do think that him and Mila were together.
Oh, really?
At least for a little while. Because when they're trying to, like, deny rumors on stage, they have this little bit about how they're not together. And you probably remember this, but...
Let me see.
Oh, my God. Isn't that crazy? Obviously, I feel like they were together. They're groping each other on stage.
I really feel... What year was that?
2010.
I really feel like culture has gotten a lot more prude since then. Because I'm like, oh my God! I can't believe it happened on stage.
That's so weird to me.
He grabbed her boobs and then she grabbed his dick.
Mm-hmm. And, like, maybe that's just really good publicity, but...
Yeah. That's... Insane.
I think they... Because also she had just broken up with Macaulay Culkin after 9 years of dating.
Oh, my goodness. So many couples were mentioning in this episode.
I know,
So many potential couples. And there's just a shot of Robert Pattinson and Kristen Stewart in that. That's so cool.
That was tough to see.
Oh, that's so sweet. What did they think of that?
I know.
Were they scandalized?
I wish they would get back together.
She's engaged, but where is the wedding?
Yeah. Do you see Taylor Lautner just got married?
Yeah,
speaking of couples, congratulations.
Taylor and Taylor.
Yeah, Taylor and Taylor Lautner. Vogue magazine.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah. Who would have thought he'd be the first one of the three to
That's
get married?
That's so true. He's the last to get engaged, the first to get married.
Yeah. Congrats, Taylor Lautner.
I'm happy for him. I really am. And apparently, well, actually not apparently. I watched a few clips. Justin and Mila were very flirty during the whole press tour for Friends with Benefits. And again, he's a single man. He's free to do whatever he wants. Mm-hmm. But I just think they were probably together with an overlap between him and Jessica.
He's overlapped before.
Mm-hmm. Around this time, though, Justin is also on a press tour with Cameron Diaz to promote Bad Teacher.
Oh.
But Justin is interviewed by Vanity Fair, and they ask about Jessica Biel, and he says, she is the single-handedly most significant person in my life. In my 30 years, she is the most special person. Okay, I don't want to say much more because I have to protect things that are clear to me. For instance, her.
That's weird.
I know.
Like, stop short.
He's like mad.
Okay. There's too many girls right now.
I know.
I'm like overwhelmed.
I know, seriously. He's literally on a press tour with Cameron Diaz and Mila Kunis at the same time. And then in July, there's rumors that him and Jessica are back together.
What?
I know. And they're photographed by paparazzi riding bikes together in Toronto in August. And then in September, this is actually pretty shitty. I feel bad bringing this up, but Mila Kunis' iCloud is leaked, and there's evidence that suggests that she was with Justin Timberlake.
No way.
Mm-hmm. There's like dirty text messages and stuff.
Whoa.
So I think they were together. Yeah. It was interesting because they were denying it, which is like they don't owe us that, but it seems to have started when he was with Jessica. In October, Jessica attends Justin's premiere for his new film In Time with Olivia Wilde. And a source says they became more and more affectionate at the premiere, sneaking kisses, whispering to each other, and sharing quick back rubs and caresses.
Back rubs?
And at one
at a
point,
premiere.
Mm-hmm, and at one point, she pretended to punch him a couple times, and he gamely bounced up and down like a jack-in-the-box.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So it seems like they're back together. In November, they both attended the GQ Men of the Year Awards and walked the red carpet solo, but apparently were inseparable at the party and were seen kissing and cuddling the whole time.
Hmm.
And even though Mila Kunis was honored with GQ's Knockout of the Year Award, which I don't know if they still do that. That's really weird. She did not attend the event.
Hmm.
In December, okay, this is so weird.
Okay.
December of 2011, Jessica's brother, Justin Biel, who apparently was working for Justin Timberlake's tequila company called 901 Tequila, which is weird because isn't Kendall Jenner's tequila company called like 918 or something? Like, are they all
no
just
idea.
Doing like area codes?
Maybe 90210.
Yeah, 901.
90210 is Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
Right.
So his tequila company is called 901 Tequila.
Okay.
And Jessica's brother worked for the tequila company.
Oh.
And after leaving the company for unclear reasons, he posts a long video rant about how Justin apparently sabotaged the company by refusing to promote it. And in this rant, he says, I've been waiting for him to do something with this fucking brand, make a song about it, put it in a goddamn video, hold it up, take some pictures. I don't care. Just do something because we're dying on the motherfucking vine here. 901 Tequila mixes well with a bump of cocaine. 901 Tequila, Steve Jobs used to drink it. Oh man, that's too soon because Steve Jobs just died. 901 Tequila, I only shit my pants once on it. 901 Tequila, so goddamn exclusive, our own CEO doesn't even drink it.
Oh my god.
I know. This is Jessica's brother. And then he says, sales dropped drastically last year. Way to go, sales team. Our distribution partners still couldn't give two fucks about the brand. Repping Patron all the way and giving us all the old fists up the ass.
Whoa. Mm-hmm. Whoa. So, why is Justin Timberlake even doing that business?
I don't know. It sounds like he was a very neglectful business
God.
Partner. It sounds like the company was like really fucked up. Like they were really like struggling and he didn't care.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. But so then a rep for the company responds and said that Jessica Biel's brother, Justin Biel, that video was meant to be a part of a marketing campaign that had dropped prematurely.
That doesn't make sense.
No, that's a lie.
Yeah. It's totally a lie.
That's not true.
That sounds so bad.
So we're kind of catching Justin in a lie here.
Yeah, true.
I don't think we can trust him. But that didn't really affect Jessica and Justin's relationship. Justin, her boyfriend, because then they reportedly get engaged.
What? Mm-hmm. Well, I knew that they'd been married for 10 years, but...
Mm-hmm. It's interesting because they broke up and I feel like he really was dating other people, but then they get back together pretty soon after and I feel like they get engaged right away, right after getting back together.
Interesting.
So it's like the breakup showed them that they were meant to be together.
I guess so.
Kind of. Then in 2012, January, Justin's grandmother, once again, Sadie, tells Radar Online that the engagement rumors are true. Yes, Justin is engaged. Jessica will be a lovely member of the family. They don't know if the wedding will be in Memphis or Colorado. It's all very new. They haven't made any plans yet. Justin, his mom and dad, and Jessica have all been in Montana all Christmas and New Year, and that's when he proposed. Justin rang me himself Christmas Day to tell me about the engagement, and apparently they got engaged at a resort in Montana, and I found a clip of Jessica talking about the proposal. I thought I'd share. Ooh. So you can hear her voice.
Jessica, let's start here. You and your husband, Justin. I didn't realize. What date did you get married?
October 19th.
Oh, okay, so we were in September, but we're both coming up on a 10 years of marriage.
Okay. Yeah.
Talk to me, which I don't know, I don't think I know this story. How did he propose to you?
It was so nice and so sweet and so unexpected. I had no idea it was coming. We were in Montana on a piece of property that we owned at the time. We had snowboarded all day. It was in the middle of the winter. Waist-high snow, we were head-to-toe, snowboarding outfits, hats, gloves, everything. And we go up to the property to just check out, you know, how the foundation is looking and all this stuff. And all of a sudden, he gets down onto his knees and just sinks into the snow. And then he looks up at me and pulls up this ring. And it was the most lovely, surprising.
You had no idea it was
hilarious.
Coming.
Hilarious. No, no.
Bold to go skiing with a ring in your pocket.
Yeah.
That is not a decision I would make. That can only
that's
backfire. That is so.
I never thought about that.
It's only if you're some kind of maverick.
Wow. I never thought
about
that.
Do you know what
that.
I mean? Who's, you know.
Yes. I mean, I should have thought about it because I had the huge glove on.
So
I was like ripping a glove off.
For the first time, I'm questioning Justin Timberlake. Now I think about it. I think this is a nuts way to propose. But I love that he did it.
That's confidence, I guess.
Yeah. Well, he is not lacking in confidence. That's why we love the chap. Now, David, I want to talk.
David Spade was sitting next to her, just silent the whole time.
Yeah. There were some loopholes in that story, though. That
really?
It's like he went skiing with a ring in his pocket. That made me be like, did that even happen the way that she described?
I think it's possible.
Okay, yeah. I don't know. I felt like...
I actually just got these rain pants, they're called, for the Iceland trip I went on. They're kind of like snow pants for rain. It's like a raincoat for your
cool.
pants.
Yeah.
And they have really great zippers on the pocket, so I don't know.
That's true.
I feel like he's rich. He probably has wicked good ski gear.
That's true.
I don't think it's crazy to think he would have a box in his pocket. It's probably not just a loose ring, right? It'd be like in a little box.
In a box. But yeah. Going down a hill? That's kind of...
If the pocket's zipped, I feel like it should be fine.
That's true. I mean, also, he has so much money that even if he loses the ring, it's probably not a big deal.
Yeah, true.
But that was making me like, did it even happen that way? Okay, I'll believe it. According to reports, though, these are not verified, but there was quite a few reports of this, that Justin and Jessica, after the engagement, were fighting about the prenup. Agreement.
Oh no.
Because she allegedly wanted a fidelity clause that would entitle her to $500,000 if he were to cheat on her.
Nice. That's kind of cool.
Yeah. Which I think is fair. I think it's fair. But I don't know if that's true. I want a fidelity clause in my prenup.
No, me too. I mean, I don't want a prenup, but. I don't even have that means of money to
think
exactly.
That
way, but it's kind of cool to be like, if you cheat on me, I get this much money.
Exactly.
Does that mean they would divorce or just means if he cheats?
No, that would have to be in the result of them getting married. But I think if he cheated, if they got divorced as a result of him cheating, which how do you really prove that?
Probably some ways.
Yeah. In this case, I think it's probably easy. So in March, Jessica is finally photographed by paparazzi wearing her engagement ring. And in the spring, from the outside, Justin and Jessica appear very in love. They are photographicationing together in Italy, and they're supposedly planning their wedding. And in May, Jessica is asked how married life will change her by the French magazine Gala, and she says, "To me, nothing will change because I'm almost never home, but when I am home, I enjoy cooking." And she says, "It will be challenging finding a balance between my private life, family, and work, and I'm ready." She also says, "For me, getting married doesn't mean we should limit ourselves to some predefined idea. Rather, it's an opportunity to explore things in life." And when asked what she likes about Justin, she says, "The ability to communicate well, to be able to express his feelings, then loyalty, and finally honesty."
Oh, damn.
She's like, is it really honesty? Like, I don't know. Loyalty, I don't know. But that's why I feel like maybe they have an open relationship, because I don't think he seems honest.
Mm.
I mean, why would she say that?
Yeah.
Maybe he says, like, by the way, I cheated on you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Maybe. Maybe they, I mean, this is jumping ahead, I guess, but, like, that's what I've heard people said about Will Smith and Jada, that they have an open relationship and that, I mean, I don't know, this is speculation, but that it's almost like they have an agreement, but they get mad at each other, or he got mad. This is about Will and Jada, not them.
Yeah.
But, like, it could be somewhere where it's, like, Will's mad at Jada because she makes him look like an asshole or something, because or it makes him look, she's not doing a good job keeping it discreet. You know what I mean?
That's what I think this is, actually. Yeah. I don't think that Justin is just cheating on Jessica and she's unaware of it. How could she be at this point? She has to be in on it, and I feel like they must have some type of agreement.
But he probably should do better keeping that really, really private.
Exactly.
And not getting the public into it.
Most people aren't going to understand that.
Yeah.
October 19th, Justin and Jessica get married.
Just back into the smiley, cheery roses.
They're in southern Italy. Justin plays guitar as Jessica walks down the aisle wearing a light pink wedding dress, which is very pretty.
Aww.
I like that she wore pink.
Yeah, that's cute.
They exchanged handwritten vows, and there's 100 wedding guests. But according to Lance Bass, Justin did not invite any members of NSYNC because he didn't want any attention taken away from Jessica. Their first dance song is to Don Hathaway's A Song for You, and the party went until 5 a.m.
What?
And then afterwards, the couple take a 9-day honeymoon in Tanzania.
Wow.
But as a gift for Justin's wedding, there's some controversy. His groomsman, Justin Hutchell, I don't want everyone's name, Justin.
What the hell?
He's a real estate agent from L.A. He puts together a video for Justin. And the beginning of the video says, "Greetings from your Hollywood friends who couldn't make it." And it's followed by a ton of homeless people in L.A. wishing Justin and Jessica good luck in their marriage. I'll show you. It's very offensive.
Jessica and Justin. Justin, I haven't seen y'all in a long time. My gift is in the mail.
What would you like to tell them?
Good luck and watch a man.
You gonna put your shirt on? Nah, I say you go skins.
Justin, Jessica, it's me, Robert. May I kill you?
Okay, that is not what I was expecting.
Yeah.
I thought that was gonna be, I thought, making a statement or something.
No, it's me. It's making fun of the homeless people.
Aww,
it's like they're
so
the
sad.
Joke. Yeah.
That's the opposite of what I thought it was going
to
be.
Yeah, and apparently they were paid like $50 to appear in it. Like, they didn't even really know, I think, what
Why would
it was
he do
for.
That?
Yeah.
I literally thought the opposite. I thought I was going to, like, make Justin feel bad. Like, oh my God, look at this lavish wedding, homeless people.
But no.
It was supposed to be a joke.
It was supposed to be a joke of, like, oh, you're out. I think it was supposed to be a joke because Justin didn't have a lot of famous friends actually going to the wedding in the first place. Like, NSYNC wasn't going. But it's really insensitive. Like, they're treating homeless people like animals. They're acting like it's
Maybe that guy was making some commentary about LA or something.
I don't know.
That is so mean.
Yeah, it's so dehumanizing. And it didn't play at Justin and Jessica's wedding, but it was like a bachelor gift or something. And Justin ends up posting an apology to his website, and he says, I'd like to start off by saying that I don't live my life making fun of people, unless, of course, I'm making fun of myself on SNL, especially those who are less fortunate or those in need. I grew up with a family and community that instilled ideals in me, like hard work, honesty, and empathy. As a matter of fact, growing up in Tennessee, I was always taught that we as people, no matter what your race, sex, or stature may be, are equal. We have a saying that everyone puts their pants on the same way. Maybe this doesn't apply to guys who wear kilts, although I'm sure they put theirs on the same way too. As it pertains to this silly, unsavory video that was made as a joke, not in any way in mockery, one, I had no knowledge of its existence. I had absolute zero contribution to it, which I believe he probably didn't know. Two, my friends are good people. This was clearly a lapse in judgment, which I'm sure no one is reading this in exempt from, but I don't believe it was made to be insensitive. More so, I think it was made as a joke on me not having that many friends attending my own wedding, which is kind of funny if you think about it. Three, like many silly rumors that I have made aware, that I was made aware of this week, it was not shown at my wedding. Four, I think we can all agree that it was distasteful, even though that was not its intention. Once again, in the world that we live in, where everyone thinks that they know everything, I want to be clear, I am not defending the video. I agree with the overall consensus, but to use another pants analogy, it seems that these days misconception gets around the world before the actual truth even wakes up and gets its pants on.
Why does a friend do that?
I know.
How did the world even hear about that? That's what I don't get.
I don't know. Why was it even posted on YouTube? Why is it still up on YouTube?
Oh, yeah, it's still on YouTube. But, jeez.
It's kind of, I don't know, a bad way to start a marriage. Like, if I was Jessica Biel, I'd be
pissed.
I know.
Like, I don't want this fucking clouding over my wedding. You only get one wedding. Well, some people get more.
I know. That'd be so offensive if anybody did that. Like, you don't even have to be a celebrity, but, like, very, very rich people are then making fun of homeless people.
I know. It's so sad. I do. I don't think he would have known about that, though. Like, if it was a gift or surprise.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, why would he know?
No, I don't think so.
It seems like his friend just has shitty ideas.
Yeah. But you do have to think, like, people kind of, like, they are their friends. Like, but maybe...
Hey, I don't want to be responsible for
I think what's more revealing about that, what's more revealing is that he didn't have many friends attending his wedding in the first place, which is like, why?
I know.
It's kind of weird. But you know what?
What?
It was a destination wedding. It was in Italy.
Oh, yeah, true.
Maybe they didn't want a tent. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's expensive.
I mean... Yeah, he's not friends with other rich, famous people.
He's also probably, he's dated so many women in Hollywood. He's probably burned so many bridges.
Yeah, probably.
He's probably dated, like, everybody's ex.
Yeah.
2013, by all accounts, him and Jessica seem very in love. They're photographed a ton together, being very affectionate and lovey-dovey, and things...
Well, that's good.
...seem good in the press. And he even dedicates his song Mirrors to Jessica. It's supposedly about her, and the music video compares their relationship to his grandparents' relationship, which was a 63-year marriage.
Wow.
And in April, Justin's on Ellen, and he talks about their getting married, and I'll play a clip.
Jess was here last time she was here. I was asking what she loves about being married, and she said her favorite thing about being married is being able to say my husband. That's what she loves.
That's it.
That's awesome. What is your favorite thing about Jess? What's the favorite thing about being married?
Calling her my husband.
I knew you would say
that. I don't know. You know, I just kind of, every once in a while, I could catch a glimpse of her when she doesn't see me looking. And I had this moment where I'm like, if you never make a good decision, if you only make bad decisions for the rest of your life, you made one really good decision. Because she's just like, she is, you know, it's just nice to marry your friends, nice to marry your best friend. Mm-hmm. It suits me.
Yes, it does. Yeah. It does suit you. I'm very happy for you.
Thank you.
Jessica is beautiful, I just gotta say it.
She is really beautiful.
So beautiful.
But doesn't that make you think, like, they really are in love?
That was really sweet.
Yeah.
Oh.
Which is why it's confusing.
And Ellen seemed so sweet.
I know. I know.
She's like, I got you a wedding gift.
Yeah. It's probably some joke gift, but...
Yeah, she's used to opt it, but...
Yeah.
That is really nice.
I think they genuinely are best friends, mm-hmm. him and Jessica.
Mm-hmm.
Which why I think they must have some agreement with each other
mm-hmm.
that it's not monogamous, but to make it seem like it's monogamous.
Yeah, maybe. We haven't really gotten into cheating as a married couple yet, though.
No,
I think I do know that happens.
With married couples?
No, with them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, true. Okay, yeah. Hang tight. I think you just met with people in general.
No.
In August, Jessica changed her name to her last name to Timberlake.
Oh, wow.
I know.
Jessica Timberlake. Mm-hmm. People don't call her that, though.
No. And in October, Justin was in Rio for the Rock in Rio Festival, and there are reports that he was seen making out with a Brazilian actress named Thyla Alea.
So Justin!
There you go, it was a married couple. She even posted an Instagram video of him performing.
Justin.
Mm-hmm. And in November, Justin attends the American Music Awards alone, and people think it's because him and Jessica are having troubles. And then she tweets, I'm watching from home tonight. Calm down, internet. But, like, that doesn't clear anything up. Why are you home?
She just wanted to be cozy.
Yeah.
Maybe she's just a homebody.
Mm-hmm.
She wants to watch with her popcorn.
No, okay, that's fair.
No, I'm trying to be like devil's advocate.
But it's like, that's not an excuse. I'm watching from home tonight.
I know.
It's like, that doesn't tell us anything. 2014, Justin wins the People's Choice Awards and thanks Jessica in his speech. And I'll share that.
And I'd like to thank my beautiful wife for teaching me patience and the little things like just putting the dishes in the dishwasher. It goes a long way. Fellas, you're welcome. Thank you. Have a good night.
Very normal thing to say.
Mm-hmm. Very normal. Sounds a little bit pre-rehearsed.
Yeah.
Mm.
But I'm kind of glad in a way, because there's a really quick second I was worried he wasn't going to have anything to say.
Yeah.
He's like, the little things, like... Can't think of anything.
Like, I don't think... They're so rich, I don't even think that he... That's an argument they probably even have.
I wonder. I know, you think they would
they
have a
They have a housekeeper.
Or,
yeah.
I don't know.
But it was sweet. I mean, it's like, I believe them. Mm-hmm. Like, when they're, like, publicly loving on each other.
I would love to have a housekeeper. Sorry, I'm just still stuck on this. But I also think I would not like to have people in my house. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I feel like I would feel judged by a housekeeper.
I just want my alone time.
And I would feel guilty about them cleaning up after me, too.
Yeah.
Pretty much so many people that I went to college with had clearly never cleaned up after them.
Really?
Yeah. So many people, because I went to a school where, like, a lot of people had been rich.
Mm-hmm.
It was obvious that so many people had housekeepers growing up. And I think that's unattractive.
Yeah.
I want someone who, like, knows how to clean up after themselves.
Anyway, that is sweet, though.
Mm-hmm. But then an Irish tabloid, The Heat, publishes photos with a headline, Justin Timberlake gets flirty with another woman. It is not his wife. And actually, Justin and Jessica then file a defamation suit against this tabloid, wow, stating that the article was based on an unfounded report regarding Justin Timberlake's alleged behavior at a club following a party in Paris to celebrate a birthday, and also included a number of statements improperly attributed to Jessica Biel, which the Heat now understands had never been made by her. And they even reach a settlement with the magazine. But it's just kind of weird because it's like there have been so many cheating rumors by Justin in the past. Yeah. And this is like the first and only time they ever filed a defamation suit.
Interesting. Perplexing.
And then in September, Justin is accused of cheating again in Star Magazine. And they even published photos of him with a backup dancer named Xenia Bashford, and here are the photos. I mean,
he's full on like making out with her and doing some weird hugging.
Yeah. It's like, are you gonna file a defamation suit there? Like, I think
I don't think they can. There's evidence.
Yeah.
Wow.
So,
Justin!
That's like interesting because if they are open, Jessica is never photographed doing stuff like this.
He's sloppy.
2015, on January 31st, his birthday, Justin posts a photo kissing Jessica's pregnant belly to announce that she's having a baby, and their first son, Silas Randall Timberlake, was born in April.
Wow.
And they both seem very affectionate. Yeah, that they have kids.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're moms and dads.
How many people are there?
You're a mom and a dad. They're both very affectionate on Instagram. There's too many instances to talk about, but on her birthday, he wrote on Instagram, "Happy B-Day to my sweetest, most gorgeous, goofiest, most badass chick I know. You make me smile till it hurts. I love you like crazy. Your huzz." Just cute. In October, Justin is inducted into the Memphis Music Hall of Fame and starts to cry when he thanks Jessica. And
here we go.
First, I want to thank my beautiful, loving, and incredibly understanding of her husband's shortcomings wife. Jessica. Now listen, she's not from here, but she built like she is. Every Southern boy, can I get a hell yeah? Y'all know how we like them. I like them bony girls. We eats down here with a S at the end. We eats. No, seriously, she is a rock. And she is tough as nails, so she's basically a Memphian. Baby, I love you more than I can put into words, or more than any song I could ever write. We actually just celebrated our third year anniversary, so. Which in Hollywood years, that's like a 15-year anniversary, so good on you, girl. I didn't drive you too crazy yet.
Obviously, you guys can't see it, but I feel like his face looks so serious.
Yeah.
Like, he really is on the verge of tears when he's talking about her. But it is weird. He's like, she's built like she is. Like, we like to eat. She's very thin.
I know. Then that prompted me to Google Jessica Biel butt.
Does she have?
She does have a nice booty.
Let me see.
She is thin, but look at this picture.
Oh, is that edited?
I don't know. It might be.
She has a decent butt. Like, it's pretty. Oh, it is pretty. Oh, wait, that's Kim Kardashian. That's not. Oh, she does have good boobs. Okay, that sounds
is this
like.
Edited?
She is in that movie, actually. I now pronounce you Chuck and Larry. Remember, she like strips down. They very much objectify her body in that.
She's got some nice curves.
Oh my God, I'm on my work laptop right now.
Jessica Biel, butt. It is interesting, though, that right from the beginning, he starts off saying, like, and I can't remember the exact quote, but something like, your husband's shortcomings.
Yeah.
It's like his right away acknowledges him messing up or something.
Yeah.
And then on the verge of tears.
Mm-hmm. Which, it's, like, tough, because I feel like, this is what I'm learning with this podcast, too, is, like, we're all bringing in our own values that we would have in a relationship. And so for myself, I'm like, I wouldn't be in an open marriage, I don't think. Yeah. I don't. If I'm married to someone, I don't want them sleeping, flirting, thinking about anybody else. Like, that's just me. But they might have an agreement where that's okay. Mm-hmm. Or not, maybe not okay, but she's just willing to be forgiving of it, and that's fine.
Maybe.
And maybe that makes them even closer.
Mm.
Like, it does seem like they really do love each other.
But then why does he seem upset?
Also, why is it then a shortcoming?
I know.
If it's allowed.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe he's really guilty about it.
But sometimes people have agreements in their relationships and people still break them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But then it's not really an agreement.
Yeah. I mean, like, sometimes people, like, couples will say, like, okay, you can hook up with someone, but you can't, like, have a full-on relationship with someone else. Or, like, you can make out with someone or something, but you can't, like, have sex with them. Or, like, and then someone, like, goes beyond that limit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But we don't know. They might not. I mean, do we know? Do they have an open relationship? Like,
I hope they do.
Because it could be just straight up cheating, but.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm very confused by this, and it's going to keep going. So in 2016, Jessica writes and produces an indie film called The Book of Love, and Justin Timberlake is the composer for it and the music supervisor. The film is very bad, though. It premieres at Tribeca Film Festival in April of that year and is met with poor reviews and only receives an 8% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Mm-hmm.
I know. And then in October, Justin told Variety, my life has changed and is changing, so it's important to discover that there's work you can do where you get more time with your family. He says, I wouldn't go on tour next week because I want to be with my son, I want to be with my wife. Just sweet. And then in November, they're photographed kissing on the set of her film, Shock and Awe. They're like making out.
Mm.
And in 2017, it's October, it's their fifth wedding anniversary. Actually, wait, didn't they get married in December? Oh, no, they got proposed in December.
Okay.
Or engaged in December. Married in October. So for their fifth wedding anniversary, Justin posts several videos of himself in a studio singing, like freestyle. And then there's a picture of them at the end that's like multiple videos. And the lyrics are, I know your image of me is what I hope to be. I treated you unkindly. But darling, can't you see there's no one more important to me? Baby, can't you see through me?
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Which I think is acknowledging that he cheats on her. 2019, Jessica dressed up as NSYNC Justin Timberlake for Halloween. And he dressed up as a microphone, which is pretty cute.
Aww. Let me see. Oh my God, she's him.
That's cute.
They do look cute.
And in November, Justin is in LA filming a movie, Palmer, and is caught on video. Oh wait, I'm talking about this as if it's not like a huge deal. He's caught on video looking way too close with his co-star, Alicia Wainwright, at a bar. He was like touching her waist. That's her hand on his thigh. There's pictures where he's her hand is like on his thigh and he's holding her hand.
Oh no. Yeah, it looks like they're holding hands. but like trying to be subtle about it.
Yeah.
Oh no.
I mean, he is drinking.
Oh jeez.
Not yeah. They're way too cozy.
And what's then, this screenshot you have here?
I don't remember. Let's see. It says, I think it's a blind item. Oh wait, no. No, Justin posted this.
Oh, okay.
I stay away from gossip as much as I can, but for my family, I feel it is important to address recent rumors that are hurting the people I love. A few weeks ago, I displayed a strong lapse in judgment, but let me be clear, nothing happened between me and my co-star. I drank way too much that night, and I regret my behavior. I should have known better. This is the example I want to set for my son. I apologize to my amazing wife and my family for putting them through such an embarrassing situation, and I am focused on being the best husband and father I can be. This was not that. I am incredibly proud to be working on Palmer. Looking forward to continuing to make this movie and excited for people to see it.
Aww, I know. Again, Justin.
I mean, where the smoke, there's fire. What are the odds that you're on video with her hand on your thigh and you're holding her hand and like touching her waist and looking at each other like that?
Poor Jessica.
Mm-hmm.
I hope she's not just like putting up with this and is at home crying because, I don't know, she thinks she can't do better or I don't like... You know what I mean?
Well, I read according to reports that Jessica just tries to ignore any reports of Justin's cheating. Yeah, she's home with like a baby. That must Silas. Be so upsetting. Yeah. And according to Blind Items, this occurred a year after Justin had supposedly fired his long-term publicist in favor of a PR team, and that his old publicist used to be a lot better at covering this kind of stuff up.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, this is not like new behavior for Justin. 2020, they welcomed their second son named Phineas Timberlake. And cute. As recently as 2021, there are still blind items about Justin being photographed kissing other women who aren't his wife at clubs. And like I said, according to tabloids, Jessica just tries to ignore it. And in 2021, there was even a Dumois blind item about Justin titled Memphis Mouse. And it said, an A-list singer with a famous wife has been known in the past to pay off paps to not reveal his wandering ways. In 2012, he even traded info to lead People magazine writer to print something about someone else instead of exposing him. He was with his current wife at the time. Old dogs don't learn new tricks. And I was wondering, is that... Well, actually, it wasn't People magazine who... exposed Kristen Stewart cheating, but that happened in 2012.
That's true.
But
how would he know?
Yeah, he's not like in that circle. What?
Well, he was in Social Network with Jesse Eisenberg, who also worked with Kristen Stewart.
Oh, true. That's
maybe
true.
Jesse told him something.
Wait, but what other scandals happened in 2012?
There were probably worse, some smaller ones that we just don't remember.
I don't have much to say, but in this past year, Jessica and Justin both starred in a Hulu true crime series together called Candy. They're both dressed as older characters, and it's kind of cute that they're in it together.
Yeah.
And in October, they renewed their vows for their 10th year wedding anniversary, and Justin posted an Instagram that said, being married to you is the adventure of a lifetime. Run it back, baby. Run it back. I love you. That's it. That's all I have for Justin and Jessica.
Wow. They're still together.
They're still together and act as if they're very in love.
It may not seem like it, but I feel like this is one of our happiest couples. I mean, they're still together.
Yeah. I don't know.
Like, maybe not happiest, but I remember we had a listener, I'm forgetting who it was, I'm sorry, but suggested we cover someone that's still together and sent some ideas and hey, they're still together.
I have to assume that they have an agreement.
They have to have, there's got to be something.
Mm-hmm. Like, I just think, I mean, we barely know anything about them, and we knew that he was cheating on her, mm-hmm. supposedly. So, I don't think this could be a shock to her. She probably knows the error of her husband's ways, and the fact that she's still together with him, still renewing her vows, still having children with him. I think it's like, she accepts it.
Yeah. I wonder if she ever has anything with anybody else. Or if she just stands by him, by herself.
I think a lot of, I mean, it's weird because she's a celebrity too, but like for famous athletes especially, I feel like a lot of their wives just accept that like that's the way it is. And like they just like let their husbands cheat on them and they have an agreement.
I know.
That like when they're on the road, they can do whatever they want.
I feel like so many situations are like that where the man, not to like generalize, but it just seems like it happens that way where whether it's even like politicians or famous actors, it's like the man just does his thing and she looks the other way.
Yeah. I don't know if I could do that.
No. Yeah.
But
it's sad.
But it's like it is interesting because they did break up. In 2011 or 2010, and maybe they got to a point where they both said, I don't want to try to date other people, like I don't want to try to find someone new, and like they do have a close friendship, so she's saying like, I'm willing to just not care if he makes out with somebody as long as he comes home to me and I know that like we have that we share.
It's upsetting that he still feels the need to, like, chase these momentary feelings of excitement. It's like, it's, I don't know.
It's like,
it's not going anywhere. You only feel excited because it's so unknowable in the beginning. And you know what I mean? I feel like we said this last time. It's like, once you're with someone long enough, it becomes regular. And that's nice. And I don't know.
And isn't it enough to know that you can get a random person if you wanted to, but you don't need to?
Yeah.
Like, isn't that enough? But maybe as he gets older and older, he feels like, oh, I still need to see if I still got it.
I don't know. So interesting. I want to know more.
Yeah.
She should write a tell-all memoir when she's older or something.
Do you think they'll stay together?
I know.
I don't think so.
I always want people to stay together, so I know. I hope so, but I guess we should say chances of them staying together, because we usually do a percentage.
Oh, yeah, of them staying together until one of them passes away, sadly. 50, I would say.
Yeah, that seems good.
I mean, the fact that she stood by him this long, she must love him.
It could be. She could stand by him forever. I could see someday, even like 10 years from now, I mean, that's pretty long for people in Hollywood, them separating, though.
I just think it's harder as the children get older, too. Like, I do think that, I mean, not to be judgmental, but if I was a child coming of age in a family where my parents had an agreement that they could cheat on each other, that would be very confusing for me.
Yeah, I know. And then once the kids have their own lives, they might think, like, why am I even doing this anymore? That's sad. Maybe he'll change.
Maybe. I don't know. But we have to keep in mind, like, he comes from a broken family. He obviously had a weird relationship with Fergie when he was younger.
That's true.
He's never really been single his whole life. He must have some attachment issues.
Yeah.
So I'm not saying that Justin Timberlake is this bad guy.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't trust him.
He just seems to, have issues.
With self-control.
How do you say? Self-control.
But again, isn't that so funny, though, that the almost like a foundational part of his career was built on the fact that he was supposedly cheated on by Britney Spears.
I know. Like, that's so true. Scorned.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, are you fucking serious right now?
People do that. I knew someone in high school. Here's some tea. Anonymous. Mm-hmm. People you don't know. That he cheated on his girlfriend, but no one knew about it except for a small amount of us. Mm-hmm. And then she cheated on him afterwards. But it was, like, widely known. And he was so upset, broke up with her, like, telling everybody, blah, blah, blah. Like, people just do that sometimes. Like, they will play the victim when they can.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what else has happened.
Yeah. I mean, I don't. Actually, I was like, I'm not accusing Justin Timberlake. I don't think Justin Timberlake is probably a nice person.
He seems, I think he seems charming, and maybe he is nice to some people, but he seems like he might be a bit fake.
Yeah, I think so. I think he reminds me a lot of Adam Levine, who was recently accused of cheating.
Yeah, they seem similar.
And seems like a not really great romantic partner. Yeah. I bet Justin Timberlake is the same way.
Those pop star guys.
I'd imagine
watch
it's,
out.
Yeah, well, I imagine it does a number on your development to achieve fame at, like, 14 years old.
Yeah.
I don't think you could ever be a normal person after that.
I can't even imagine. Mm-hmm. How could someone be, like, super humble and down to earth?
No. Even, I think, being popular at that age might fuck you up. So yeah. Being a celebrity in a boy band.
I know, right?
Where you can get anybody you want.
That's actually so true. I don't want to shit on popular people. Cut this out. But it does seem like a lot of popular people like got kind of messed up.
Yeah. No, I think you can leave that in. And it's true. Yeah. Because I honestly think it builds character for you to be unpopular in high school.
Yeah. It's really... That's it, Mel. Mm-hmm. It's very important to build character.
Yeah.
And when you have everything handed to you since you're a teenager, that messes up your life view, your morals, what's right and wrong, blah, blah, blah. I feel like you lack empathy when you don't really struggle that much. Mm-hmm. Not that, I mean, I'm sure Justin has had some struggles.
Oh, yeah, he has. I mean, like I said, like, he had a sister that died.
Yeah.
He had his parents got divorced.
Yeah.
And I think when you're a kid and you have an entire, like, team that's dependent on you for money, I'm sure that fucks you up. And, you know, I don't know his parents at all, but, like, anyone who puts their kids in show business probably aren't the best parent. I hate to say it. But, so, like, I'm sure he's been through a lot.
I want to hang out with Jessica Biel and just hear, I don't know.
I know.
I don't know how she's doing.
She seems unbothered. She's kind of got the Vanessa Hudgens thing going on. Like, why are you okay with this?
Oh, my God.
Wow. I don't know.
I wonder if my mom knows about any of this. Because she suggested to me we cover this couple. But I don't know if she knew there was any cheating going on. I think she may have just thought it was, like, a nice... plain old happy marriage.
There's so many things I didn't even include. Like, they actually go on talk shows all the time, and like, they seem so cute. Like, they really do talk about each other and tell all these stories. But am I just falling for it? Like,
I know sometimes I psych myself out thinking that.
But yeah, that's Justin and Jessica. We wish them the best.
And
I was going to say, like, with this podcast, I'm definitely learning. Like, I don't want to be too critical of anybody because relationships are messy and, like, people are complicated and, like, we don't know the full story. So I want to believe that they have an agreement.
I hope so.
And
I think so.
Yeah. They have to.
Something tells me they do. Mm-hmm. And she knows. Maybe she has some hot guy that she talks to sometimes. But her and Justin are best friends and love each other. Mm-hmm. And our husband and wife still. I don't know.
Seventh Heaven.
We should watch that.
I know. Anyways. Okay, yeah, that's them.
Thank you, Mel, so dramatic.
I feel like I'm literally drunk right now.
Really? I actually feel sober.
I'm
stone cold
sober. It's because I had Tylenol earlier before
and
drinking.
And you didn't eat much today.
Because guys, I was on the stupid Ticketmaster all day. So I'm recording this on November 16th.
Mm-hmm.
And like a lot of you guys, I was on Ticketmaster all day today.
You were on Ticketmaster all for what reason?
To get Taylor Swift tickets, and I didn't get them. It was Capital One presale. And yesterday, I also moved my whole day around for this stupid thing, and I didn't eat anything today. So I'm feeling just like dead inside.
No.
And with that, I'm going to choose our next episode.
Oh.
It's about someone that I mentioned in this episode.
That's true. You did.
Yeah. And I mentioned it in 3 episodes ago.
Wow, yeah. I'm excited. Mm-hmm. I'm thrilled.
It's a controversial couple, which I think I won't drink for this episode.
Oh, really? Can I?
Yeah. I feel like I just need to use my words carefully, probably. Because I think there will be backlash.
Us.
Yeah, please go
easy on me, baby. I was just a child.
It's like so hard with some of these episodes because like everybody has mega fans and everybody has haters. And yeah. So people want you to either trash someone or defend someone.
Yeah. I had like 2 controversial couples in a row. I need to do someone that's not.
But it's boring. But honestly, I don't like anybody. Maybe there's some like diehard Justin Timberlake fans.
Yeah.
But like, I feel like no one's going to like be jumping to defend Justin Timberlake.
Watch us be so wrong.
I know.
Just kidding. I know. The couples that are just kind of happy.
I know.
But, which, like, guys, I love and romance, and I'm, like, very traditional in that way. But those couples are just not that interesting.
What's there to say? Oh, that was cute. Oh, that was cute, too.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay.
We need the roller coaster.
Yeah. Like, I was thinking of doing Melissa McCarthy and her husband.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're always in stuff together. Like, he was.
That's so unique.
It's unique, but what's there to say? They just act together.
Yeah, yeah. I said to you I wanted to do Penelope Cruz and Javier Bardem, but they seem just happy.
Mm-hmm.
I could be wrong, though. Maybe I should do some research, and then I'm like, oh.
I know. I feel like that's the thing. I don't want
to. Cheated.
Yeah, I don't want to do couples that seem happy because I don't want to find out that they're not.
Yeah.
What about couples who seem unhappy, but they are? Mm. Is that what Justin and Jessica
are? I wonder.
Because they seem unhappy, like, on surface value, but I think that they're fine.
There's a high chance they do have an open relationship. I heard, I don't know if I should cut this out, Charlie's sister was telling me just, like, where they live, which is just, like, in rural New Hampshire, that there's a lot of swingers.
Oh, yeah.
I'll just say it happens. It happens maybe more than you know.
Mm-hmm.
I know some people in open relationships or whatever, so.
Yeah.
I don't want to end it, but I guess we should.
I know. Well, thank you guys for listening.
Yes. You can email us at significantlovers@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm. And you can follow us at Significant Lovers on Instagram and TikTok.
TT.
Mm-hmm.
Does anyone call it that?
TT? Maybe. Oh, I feel like I was just going to say about TikTok. Like, all these people are like being kind of mean on TikTok. But I think that's the nature of.
I almost quit the podcast.
I think that's the nature of the platform is people just get fueled up by other people's comments and.
Well, so I don't have the app actually, but isn't it like you just kind of get shown a random thing? Like you didn't really expect it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that people don't know what the heck this is.
No.
And.
But people are so annoying. Like the Tom Brady and Bridget Moynihan one, It's like, I already told you this, so it's like this kind of performative of me. But like, people, like, I had a video about how we're talking about how there was tension between Bridget and Giselle in the mm-hmm. beginning of their relationship. And then all these people were commenting, actually, they get along really well now. It's like, we know that.
Yeah.
It's just annoying when you research something for so long and like become an expert on a couple, and then other people are trying to fact check you on something you've already talked about.
It's in the episode.
Yeah, but people obviously don't know that.
And didn't someone say, like, you're perpetuating this narrative?
Like, yeah, they're like, why are you pushing this narrative? It's like, if you actually just took time to listen to the full episode, you would know that I already know that they get along.
They don't get it.
All right, thank you guys for listening.
We love you.
We love you. We'll get back together next week.
Just like Justin and Jessica. Mm-hmm.
Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell